Yesterday, what is the visa about the types of, I mean, some examples of the condition types and visa, how the condition types are differentiated? I mean, like what keeps apart PR00 from KA01 and HA00? So, visa about the how, I mean, what are the types of condition types? That is whether price or discount or surcharge, I mean, discounts and surcharge are expenses or rebates, expense reimbursements, okay. Then taxes, visa, those things. Then visa, how the value is taken up, whether it is a positive value or negative value. Then visa about the, what is visa? Okay. I mean, like whether it is a group condition or header condition, those kind of things visa. Okay. So now once, I mean, like once you work, and at least once you create one pricing project for yourself, then it will be, everything will be easy for your people. Okay. So now let us go to the concept of condition exclusion. Okay. There are, in business scenario, sometimes we come across a scenario where we have to exclude certain conditions when some condition is there. For example, let me say that you are selling an article A for $100 in market. The cost of that article is, let me say it is $60. But your customer, you have got a new customer, and to get into relation, you are pretty? No idea why, but I can hear you pretty clearly. Okay, so let us go through the scenario. This, let me say this article A is costing $100 per piece in market. Okay. Whose cost is $60 per piece. Okay. But you are getting a new customer and you want to get into a long-term relationship with that customer. So you are trying to give them, I mean, like, so you are giving a special price to the customer. Let me say 75%. So your PR00 value becomes 75% for that customer. So over that you are going to add the customer discounts and material discounts. So once you add all these things, then your actual price that you are going to sell to the customer, it falls below 60, which means you are going to end up making losses. So to do that, what you have to do, you can check between the condition types and see, okay, which is the highest discount or which is the lowest discount. I want to apply only the favorable condition types. Okay, so you want the system to exclude certain discounts automatically when a particular condition type is on. So this is the condition exclusion. Okay. So let me create. So we have been, I mean, like one thing I have overlooked. So we have been talking about the condition types, but we didn't see about creating the condition records. So go to logistics, sales and distribution, master data, condition, create. This will take you to another screen where you have to, I mean, like this VK31 is a new functionality. It is not found in the previous versions of SAP. In this case, you can create all the prices and discounts in a single step. But if you go through select using condition type, that is VK11, you have to enter the condition type first and then enter the values then. Okay. So I go to condition records. So let me go to conditions and surcharges. Let me go by customer. So I'm going to create a discount for customer. the program. I think there is some problem with that. So let us go to the conditions. Select using condition type. Let me go to week 11. So let us see what are all the condition types that we have in our system. So I go to pricing control, define condition types, maintain condition types, no idea. No, but I can hear you people clearly. Anyway, okay, that's fine. Somebody can call me. I'm seeing like there are some promotion types. One is K00, and let me create another one. And let me create here one K00, and there'll be something more. K032. So somebody has created that. But KACS is normally for customer based discounts, whereas K and number, K001, 002, those series are for material discounts. Okay. So let me create one customer discount, so KA00. So the system is going to give me a combination. So 1010 for my customer T-A62A01. T-AT101 T-AT102, okay. 5, I'm giving 5% discount. So there are K004, next we will create the K004 or K005. So for this customer I have created a discount of, okay. So let me make it more. So I create the another discount K005, that is the customer and material combination. Okay. And this is what we did. Okay, K004. K004. Which means here I am not specifying any customer or something. Whomever buys this article, they will be getting this discount. Okay. So 10% and 10%. Okay. So let me make that 10 euro. Okay, fine. So let me save this. Now I am going to create a sales order and see the effect of pricing on this. Okay. 4R00. Condition exclusion. T-AT101. Let me give one piece itself. And similarly, T-AT102, again I want to use only one piece. Tradition mandatory pricing error is okay. Let me go to the conditions. Okay, can you see for the first article, the system has taken the discount of $395, and for the second, for the same one, I applied the discount of 15%. It calculated 59.525, and for the material discount, I gave 10 euros per piece, so it has taken 10. For the next one, I am entering PR00, which means 395. Okay. No condition record or found for PR00. So now, we had said that the system has applied both the discounts. I don't want the system to apply both the discounts. I want the system to give only one discount, which is favorable for the customer or favorable for myself. Okay, that we can define it later. So to do that, I use the concept of condition groups. So let me, in this case, I am grouping all the customer related discounts, that is KA series, into one group, and I am grouping all the material related discounts, that is K0 series into another group, and then I am going to compare both these groups and tell the system, please take which is the condition type that is most favorable or least favorable for me. So to do that, my first step starts with the grouping of conditions. So I have to create a group. So by default, the standard system, the system has two groups, 001 and 002. Okay, let me create a new group. So 008, okay, bid material. This is the material related group conditions. And the customers. So I have just, there is no other parameter here. I can just enter the number and description. Okay. I am going to assign the extra condition types to these groups. So what I do normally, I copy this 001 or the 001 series. mine is 008 is the material one. And I'm talking just copy. Then I copy the. Okay, this is not on here. Okay, so I make new entry 0009 KA K005 0009 K007 009 K004. You can understand what I did? I just created two groups. One is metal group and another one is customer discount group. And I am assigning the condition types to those groups. Okay. So I had made two groups, this versus that. Now I am going to make a comparison between them and then tell the system, okay, choose which one is applicable. So our condition type, our pricing procedure is RVAA01. Okay. So in the pricing procedure, I go to exclusion. So I make a new entry. So let me say 20. Here I have to choose what the system must do. It must compare with both the one and take the, let me say, least favorable between the condition types. In our previous scenario, what we saw in the sales order, one discount type was 59 euros and another one was 10 euros flat. I want to tell the system, choose which is least favorable for me, for the customer, which means it has to choose only the 10 euro discount. If you make it as best condition within those condition types, then it will say, it will take the, let me say like, it will take the 52 things. So, I will take the least favorable between two exclusion groups. Okay. My group one is 0008 and my another one is 0009. Okay. It is F. Least favorable between two things. So the one thing, so let us tell challenges first. Okay. So now let us go and see that in action. So before that, we had a problem of one article saying the condition record is not maintained, PR00 for PAT102. T-AT102, let me say this is 400 euros per piece. So now I am going to create a sales order VA01 condition exclusion. Hello, Abhi, are you there? So I go to the conditions now. I mean, till now what I did, I had maintained two conditions for this customer. One is the material discount and one is the customer discount. One value is 15% and one value is 10 euro flat. Now I want the system to take only the least of these both and apply in the sales order. I don't want the system to give both the condition types because I may end up making loss. So I had created two exclusion groups. and I had entered, put the conditions in those exclusion groups. Now the system will compare both the exclusion groups and tell me, okay, which is the least one or which is the most favorable, and it will take that only. So now I am going and seeing the condition. The system had taken the 59.25, okay, but it had left out the K004. Can you see the, it has yellow triangle? It says it is inactive. That is, it has been deactivated. So the system inactive, which means there is a valid condition record, but that is not active in the pricing procedure. Okay, so let us go and change that to most favorable. Maintain condition exclusion for pricing procedure. Our pricing procedure is RVAA01. Okay. I go to the exclusion. I told the system to least favorable between condition group, and now I am taking the best condition between the condition group. Come out of this also. I am going to create another sales order because VA01 OR. Condition exclusion. T-81011P. Select the, go to condition. What happened? It's still taking up the value only. I look into that. Okay. So this is the condition exclusion. Anyway, let me look into that why it is still taking that only one value. I expected the system to deactivate the 59 euros now, but it didn't do that. It still deactivated the 10% only. Okay. Anyway, this is the concept of condition exclusion. Understood? Did you understand the concept of this? Okay. Then we will go to the pricing agreement. Okay, now we had started talking about the pricing conditions. Okay, we are talking about the price PR00. We are talking about the discounts. We are now talking about the header discounts, item discounts, group conditions, everything. Okay, so based on this discount types, how you can use these discount condition types on your regular business? How you can use the discount on your regular business? On a normal business, you have seen the system had given you provision for creating and maintaining discounts. Okay, so on what scenarios you use these discounts? Pardon? Yeah. I mean, like, at what period? Okay, let me put it still more simply. At what period you normally use these discounts? This is what I was expecting. So you might be running some promotion schemes. Okay, then you create the discounts. Okay, you might be running some sales deal. You think you have these deals, no? So sometimes you run the sales deal. Then at the time you allow the discounts with a validity. So for example, you will say like, I'll give 40% on all the price group. I mean for all the apparels or footwear for this particular week. Let me say your Thanksgiving weekend or your Christmas week. Okay. So you create condition type. At the time you give the validity period. Okay. And based on your sales deal, which means like based on your like preconceived strategy, you group certain, create certain conditions and then put it in the sales deal. So when somebody says like I am going to apply a deal for this, or when I am going to create a deal for this product for this weekend, then the system automatically takes the condition type assigned to those sales deal with the validity period. Okay. So that is what, let us go and see the setup sales deal. Okay. Before that, there is something called as promotion. In SAP SD, there is no functionality, I mean not much functionality for promotion. Only thing is, the system generates a promotion number, and when you create a sales deal, you assign those sales deals to a promotion, so that when you create a sales order, if the sales deal conditions are flowing in that through your pricing, then the promotion number will also flow in the header. So, based on the promotion number, you create a report saying that, okay, for this so-and-so period, I had sold so-and-so quantity of goods of what so-and-so value. So, just to take that report, the system makes sure that a promotion number is created and it is flowing through the header detail. That's it. Other than that, there is no much functionality for promotions. So, if you go to the promotions configurations or promotion settings, what happened? Okay. So, if you go into the promotion configuration, there is not much. Only thing it says that this category is called as promotion. Okay. You cannot do anything about that. Only, so you can use what is listed here. Okay. So, and when it is valid from and when it is valid to. Okay, promotions are normally created for a validity of 1 month. Okay. Then overview screen, like what should be your screen when you are creating the promotion. Other than that, there is nothing much configuration in that. Like I said, the only functionality of the promotion is to generate a promotion number and assign it to the sales deal, so that when you create a sales order, the system automatically takes the promotion number. Okay. So now I am going to sales deal. Now this will be done when you deploy the system. I mean this is the back end configuration. Based on the setting, the user can create any number of promotions in the front end. Not clear? I mean I am saying okay, let me try to create another sales deal, so copying this. So I am saying it must start from 020. Okay, let me see. Okay. This promotion starts from first day of the month. Okay. Let me try to change this. First day of the week. I want this to be a weekly promotion. Okay. And it starts at the first day of the week and ends at, okay, current no proposal. Let me put it as no proposal so that we can, I can fill the date automatically. Okay. I am saying that this must be my weekly sales lead. Okay. What is the change I made from the normal? The normal one was the monthly proposal. It started from this month end and valid up to this month end. Okay. So, but I have slightly changed it to the my promotion, my, slightly tweaked it to my company's policy or company strategy, because we normally run the weekly promotion. Okay. Then I am saying that this is the top level sales deal. I cannot link this sales deal to some other sales deal. Okay, so I am just erasing it. Okay, so these are the only two changes I had made. Okay, but okay. Another change I am going to make is based on the condition type group. Okay, by the default system has the 0020. Okay, and let me see what are all those things available. If I go to the condition type group 0020, see, these are the things it has taken for. So, when I say a sales deal is active, the system looks for these condition values or condition records for these condition types basically. Okay. So, if any of these values are found, then the system automatically takes that value, automatically picks this condition record and takes the promotion number also. Okay. So, I don't want to change, because this existing group itself is fine, so I don't want to change it. Assign condition groups to sales deal. My newly created is Z020. Okay. For that I have assigned this group Z0020. If you want, I can change it, but as of now I don't want to. So let me go to the front end or easy access cache. I go to master data agreement. Yeah, front end. I have configured the sales deal in the back end. That's it. Okay. So that is the only thing we do when we are deploying the system. After that, while deploying the system, your client will say we do monthly promotions or we do weekly promotions. Sometimes we do ad hoc promotions. In the ad hoc promotions, you don't prefer any date. You can automatically, you can give any date range which you want. Okay. So now what we did now, we defined it as a weekly promotion, which means it will be valid for 1 week. Okay. Yeah. Okay, see. I go to sales deal. I go to sales deal, create. Okay, here I have to choose the type of sales deal. Okay, here only you can get what you have configured in the back end. So, let me choose the weekly sales deal. Yeah. Okay. So validity period, let me start it from today. And you wanted it for 2 weeks, which means up to 19th you wanted. Up to 19th. So this external description is what that goes to the POS system normally. Okay. If you are handling your sales through point of sale system, then that must know, okay, why this discount is being given. So at the time we give the, so let me say it as a fortnight promotion. So now I click the condition. So whatever conditions I had assigned it to a condition group, and that condition group I assigned to a sales deal. So the system will pick up all those condition types and tell me whether, what are all the condition types I am going to use for this. Okay. So for in the condition group 0020, these 5 condition types were there: customer discount, price group discount, and price. Okay. So let me create the condition records for the existing one. So K001, K007, I am creating a new condition record. I am saying for this customer T-S62A01, I want to give some 10%. Okay. Then for customer, I think it will be there already. So for price group, for any material that falls under the price group, I want to give 00, price group 01, I want to give 5%. 02, sorry, 10%. 03 is 10%. Okay. So based on the price group of my material, the system will automatically take the. Okay. So I go back. Okay. So these are the only configurations I did. Price is already there and promotion is already there. So let the system take from that. Okay. So I have created a sales view. So let me. So let me save this. Number is does not exist for a bit. Interval. We must maintain the number range. Maintain number range for agreement. No. This is regarding the number range. So when you create a number range, I mean rebate as sales deal, so the system must automatically assign the number range. So not assign, can you see, okay. So G020, because we created newly. So we created the new one, okay. So I am assigning this to G020 is taken into this. Now I go to VB21. to do the turn again. Select the conditions. So customer so let me make it as from 12 points, it can be differentiated. So for another one, for material group I want to give an addition or price group. Okay. So condition record 01, 02, 03, that is 5%, 10% and 15%. Okay. So I had created a sales bill. I'm going to save it. So sales bill 92 has been created. So let us create a sales order slash VA01 OR. Sales B 92. T-8101, T-102. Order quantity is 1 piece. I go to the conditions. So our condition exclusion is active in the one thing. Just now we saw about the condition exclusion, no? So which one is most favorable or which one is least favorable, the system deactivates this. So since that is active, so we are getting those things. So let me remove that exclusion now. What is our present procedure? It is RBAA01. I go to the exclusion. I can remove that. Okay. I don't want anything right now because I don't want the system to carry out any exclusion activities right now. Come out, slash in. Now you are familiar with your transaction code, Abid? I think you must be, since you are in the project. Okay. And what is the nature of your project? Is it implementation or rolling out? Okay. Who is the client? Who is the client for whom you are implementing? For whom you are implementing SAP? Pfizer Pharmaceuticals. Okay. Who is the implementation partner? Siemens, sir. The implementation partner, which IBM is doing that for you? Okay. Okay. I mean, global template is why? Because, and now, I mean, your implementation will be done in your head office or your US part first. Later, subsequently, it will be rolled out to each country. So that is why like the subsequent process is called as rollout. Okay, this is your first thing. Okay. Okay. Mm. Okay, so if you come back, so in the screen you can see all the discounts what we have created for the sales deal, it is showing now. We didn't create them separately using K07. Instead, what are the things we created? We created now the price group K020 and K007 are the two condition types we created as a part of this sales deal. Okay. So that has flown into this thing. Okay. So now I come to this, I go to header data. No. This is the same pin number. Okay, so I'll do one thing. Okay, now since we have created the sales bill and with the condition type, so based on the validity of the condition record, so the system is automatically taking the value of condition records into your pricing procedure. Okay, so that means the sales bill is very simple actually. So another thing is, instead of you going through and creating the condition types separately in week 11, you create everything in your sales bill screen. Okay. And let us go to the promotion, okay. Master data, agreement, and promotion. Seems to be. Maybe because it is easy access, okay. Okay. Create promotion 0030. Okay. So in the promotion series I mean there is nothing much, okay. So I'm just entering the Abir promotion. So my, let me change the validity from today 0508 to 19. That's same. I created the promotion 93. I had my creating the promotions too. Yeah, this is what sent them to me. Yeah. Okay. So let us do one thing. Let me go and delete the previous sales bill. Because if I create this, if I create the same condition types again and again, then it will be. So I go to 92. Please change. Let's do one thing. I can remove all the condition records. So I delete it. We need to do. So create a sales mail. Okay. Just now I created a promotion and I am assigning this promotion number to this. Okay. Description sales mail to promo. Okay. Description is sales mail. Link to this promotion. Okay, my this thing is 15/02/19. Okay. So I create a condition for this K007. My customer discount. Let me give only two discounts. One is the customer discount and price group discount. For the customer, I am giving 13%, not the different value. So, for the another price group, so let me give 01, 02, 03, 99, 5, 7, and 9%. The system took the validity based on your promotion period. So, our promotion was from I had wrong entered the data. Okay, system is does not change the validity period. Okay, fine. So now I go to the condition, I change the validity of those. Type group also to maintain it. Now I have saved it. Okay, fine. I don't mind. Load it. Okay. I have created the sales bill 94. So before that, let me. There is one sales bill 92 that is having some value. So let me delete this value. Not 94. Okay, it has been deleted automatically. So now I am going to create a sales order VA01. Sales B promotion. I go to the conditions to see what are all the discounts that had flown into. Okay. So we maintain K007 and with now. So I deliver this. So what is my plan? 1200 and delivery date is. Because I am trying to show that when you go to the billing, the system must take the your promotion number as well as the sales bill number. So I am trying to deliver this so that I can create a billing. Do you remember that delivery creation billing? When was the last time you created the delivery? Last weekend. Okay. Where today the network is so slow. Bangalore. No, actually it is raining. Rain season has started. Could be because of that. Because your broadbands are here, broadbands are cable based. I think it's going to get disconnected. It is rolling. Yeah, okay. That's fine. We can take it up tomorrow. Yeah. Then I can create everything in recording and then that also sounds good actually. Point noted. Yeah, because it is recorded from my side, so there are the Yeah, I'll do that. Because I was just waiting for this condition explosion point. Okay, now I'll send everything together. Because these are all part of the same unit actually. I have to follow the SAP the certification material. So based on their pattern, everything comes under the same thing. Okay. 012. Transaction code. Okay. Okay, I will try. Posting is possible on the okay, they hadn't closed it. Okay, we will catch up tomorrow. There are some more settings to do this. Okay, yeah, see you.